Adelaide is about to undergo major renovations, the government introducing sweeping changes to the city's planning laws. For the first time in decades, developers will be allowed to build significantly skywards thanks to relaxed height restrictions.
Adelaide's skyline is about to be supersized. The state government revealing the biggest changes to city planning laws in decades, permitting buildings of 30 stories in some areas, about the same height as the CBD's tallest skyscraper, Westpac House.
We think this is the missing ingredient, the catalyst for what will be a cascade of investment dollars into the South Australian city.
Development approval times for projects costing more than $10 million will be cut from 180 days to as little as 10. The changes, effective as of tomorrow, expected to unlock $500 million from developers unwilling to invest under the city's outdated laws.
And I think we'll see more people on the streets, which will give Adelaide a buzz which I don't think it's had for the last 60 years.
It's hoped these sweeping changes will help end decades of bickering between the City Council and the state government over how the city should look.
It's not about power, it's not about who does what. It's actually about focusing on what's good for the City of Adelaide.
But divisions remain in the community.
Well, I'm sort of more of a country person. I don't like all the high-rise buildings, really.
I just think it's time for us to catch up with the other states.
The government also outlining its preferred route for an inner city tram loop, taking in Frome Street, Hurtle, Whitmore and Light Squares and West Terrace. Only problem is, there's no money in the budget.
In the future, once there is the capacity in the budget, that's something we would like to do.
Adam Todd, 10 News.